from HowIPinchAPenny.com, and we're learning how to make gourmet marshmallows. Yes. I've already eaten one. It's delicious. So let's get into this. What do we start with?
You're going to start with sugar.
Okay, that makes sense.
Very important. And gelatin. This is gelatin, not Jell-O.
Okay, gelatin.
Yes, and you're going to find this near the Jell-O. It's either going to be below it on the shelf or above it on the shelf, depending on the store that you're in.
Great.
So you're going to bloom your Jell-O, your gelatin, which means you're going to have a little bit of water. It's about 3/4 cup.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to sprinkle it over top, and then it will do just that. It will bloom.
Okay.
It's really cool to watch.
Oh, that is neat.
It is.
So we're going to have the sugar, the gelatin, some vinegar, or some corn syrup.
Okay. So while that is blooming in your pot,
mm-hmm.
on the stove, you're going to put corn syrup, water, salt, vanilla, and granular sugar.
Ooh, okay.
Here's the scary part. You're going to boil it. And you're going to boil it with a candy thermometer till you reach softball stage, which is 240, 250.
Okay, so once we get there, is it time to whip?
Yes, it
okay.
is.
Okay. So this is pretty cool because we have a demonstration of what it looks like whipped.
Yes.
And that is It's thick and it's sticky.
It is. It's thick and sticky. And this has been whipping for 10 minutes. And then what you want to do is you're going to grease your pan with your parchment or your wax paper in it.
Okay.
And just put it in there. Put some spray on your hands.
And spread it out.
Push it down.
Perfect.
And then you're going to let set overnight, 8 to 10 hours. And what everything is doing is it's congealing up and it's setting.
And I love, because we have a piece over here that you've already cut, and you just kind of tinted this.
Yes, a little bit of just food coloring. You could also flavor it with fruit juices or extracts. And what I'm doing is I have sprayed my pizza wheel.
Oh, so it doesn't stick.
So it doesn't stick.
That's such a great idea.
Yeah, and then this is equal parts powdered sugar and rice flour.
So we're just going to coat it?
We're just going to coat it. We're just going to go round and round.
Oh, my goodness. And it looks fantastic. And I love how you decorated these. These are a little minty green. And then you
yes.
just put white chocolate on top,
white
right?
White chocolate that has been tinted with a little bit of color. You can personalize them. These are great for Easter. I was thinking this would be great as a takeaway for a wedding.
Oh, such a
Wouldn't
cool
idea. Wouldn't that be
idea.
Fun? You could put monograms
is.
On them.
And you were saying that some of these would maybe cost you 50 cents, maybe a dollar, depending on the shop that you went to.
Yeah.
And to buy all these supplies, it wasn't that expensive, right?
It really was. I mean, I have sugar in stock. I've got corn syrup.
And you guys have those things in your pantries,
yeah,
too. So
definitely.
We all have it.
As long as you have found your rice flour, you're good to go.
So rice flour.
Yeah.
And we can get the recipe on your website, right?
You definitely can.
All right. Well, we'll have a link to howipinchapenny.com on fox43.com. Sarah, we'll see you next time. Thanks.
Great. Thanks for having me.
I'm going to eat another one.